أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وقال إني ذاهب إلى ربي سيهدين، رب هب لي من الصالحين، فبشرناه بغلام حليم. صدق الله العظيم. We were reading in Surah As-Saffat when Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was thrown in the fire, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept him safe. But after that, as a rule, when for any messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala people try to kill him, then he makes hijrah from that place. He immigrates to other land. So immediately after that he said, قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي ظَاهِرٌ إِلَىٰ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. And he said, surely I am going to my Lord, he will certainly guide me. The history tells us that he went from Iraq to Sham, Syria, because in between is a very big desert. So he had to take a very long route. But then after reaching the northern part of Syria, then he came down to the Palestine of this age, this time. رَبِّ هَبْ لِي مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. At the same time, he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, grant me a righteous offspring. فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ. So we gave him the glad tidings of a forbearing son. This word Haleem appears in the Quran only thrice for any human beings. Always it comes from Allah only, forbearing. But twice for Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, and once for Ismail alayhi salam, this word comes in Quran. Here, فَبَشَّرْنَاهُ بِغُلَامٍ حَلِيمٍ. We gave him the glad tidings of a forbearing son. That is Ismail alayhi salam. فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَاهُ السَّعِيَ. When he reached the age of working alongside his father, قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ. It was at the age of 13. Hazrat Ismail was 13. قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَصْبَحُكَ. He said to the son, Ismail alayhi salam, oh my dear son, I have been seeing in my dream that I am slaughtering you. فَانْزُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى. Now look, what is your opinion? What do you say? قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ فَعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرْ. He said, oh my dear father, go ahead and do what you are being ordered and commanded to do. Satajaduni inshaAllah min as-sabirin. God willing, you will find me from among the persevering. Falamma aslama. When both of them submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, watallahu lil jabin, and he had laid him down over his forehead. وَنَادَيْنَاهُ وَيَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ. He was just going to slaughter him, kill him. When Allah says, we call to him, saying, O Ibrahim, قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. You have indeed fulfilled your vision. إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And we reward those who reach the level of excellence in their deen in the same way. We have tried and you have succeeded. But no further, don't kill the son. إِنَّ هَذَا لَهُوَ الْبَلَاءُ الْمُبِينُ. Verily, it was a very big test through which you have come with flying colors. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ and we ransomed him for a mighty sacrifice. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ and we left for him praise among the later generations. All are praising Ibrahim, the Jews, the Christians, the Muslims, all, and maybe even the Hindus. There is an idea that Brahma, which they call is a deity, it is actually the name of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. They have made him God, just as the Christians made Hazrat Masih alayhi salam son of God. So these things are the perversions of the people. Maybe they also mean Ibrahim when they call Brahma. Salamun ala Ibrahim, peace be upon Ibrahim. Kazalika najdil muhsaneen, in this way we reward the good doers. Innahu min ibadina al-mu'mineen, surely he was among our believing servants. Wabashsharnahu bi Ishaq, and later on we gave him the glad tidings of Ishaq, nabiyya min as-salihin, that he will be a prophet from among the righteous. Wabarakna alayhi wa ala Ishaq, and we blessed him and also Ishaq. Wabin zurriyatihima, and from the progeny of both of them, both of them, progeny of Ibrahim and Ishaq, that is, the progeny of Ismail is not covered here, progeny of Ibrahim and Ishaq. وَمِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِهِمَا مُحْسِنٌ وَظَالِمٌ لِنَفْسِهِ مُبِينٌ, there are good doers of the good deeds also, and there are wrongdoers also, who are manifestly in error. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَى مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ, and we did confer a favor on Musa and Harun alayhim as-salam. وَنَجَّيْنَاهُمَا وَقَوْمَهُمَا مِنَ الْكَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ, and we delivered them and their people from the mighty distress. وَنَصَرْنَاهُمْ فَكَانُوهُمُ الْغَالِبِينَ, and we helped them so they became the victors. وَآتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ الْمُسْتَبِينَ, and we gave them the book which gave them the light. وَهَدَيْنَاهُمَ الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ, and we guided both of them to the straight path. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِمَا فِي الْآخِرِينَ, and left for them also the praise among the later generations. سَلَامٌ عَلَى مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ, peace be upon Musa and Harun. إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِي الْمُحْسِنِينَ, surely in this way we recompense the good doers. إِنَّهُمَا مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, surely both of them were from among believing servants. وَإِنَّ إِلْيَاسَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, in the same way Ilyas was also from among the messengers. إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ لَا تَتَّقُونَ, when he said to his nation, don't you fear God? أَتَدْعُونَ بَعْلًا, do you call upon Baal? Baal was their god, and that is why there was a city, Baal Bak, city of Baal. Baal was the god whom these people, you know, they worshipped. Atadruna Baalan, you call upon Baal, Watadaruna Ahsan al Khaliqeen, and you are forsaking the best of the creators, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Rabbakum, that is Allah, who is your Lord. فَرَبَّ آبَائِكُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ, and he is the Lord of your forefathers also. فَكَذَّبُوهُ, so they belied him. فَإِنَّهُمْ لَمُحْضَرُونَ, so they will also be presented before us as criminals. إِلَّا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ الْمُخْلَصِينَ, except those of our servants whom we had chosen for ourselves. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ, and we left for them praise in the coming generations. سَلَامٌ عَلَىٰ إِلْيَاسِينَ, peace be upon Ilyas. إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجْزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ, إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. وَإِنَّ لُوتًا لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ, and Lut was also from among the messengers. إِذْ نَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ أَجْمَعِينَ, when we delivered him and his family all. إِلَّا عَجُوزًا فِي الْغَابِرِينَ, except an old woman, his wife. She remained with those who remained behind. ثُمَّ دَبَّرْنَا الْآخَرِينَ, then we destroyed the others. وَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَبَرُّونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مُصْبِحِينَ وَبِاللَّيْلِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ, and verily you pass by them in the morning and at the night. The caravans, you know, trading caravans which used to go from Hijaz to Syria, passed by these, you know, cities of Gomorrah and Sodom. So إِنَّكُمْ لَتَبَرُّونَ, you keep on passing by their cities. عَلَيْهِمْ مُصْبِحِينَ, in the mornings, wa bil layl, and during the night also, afala taqilun. So do you not understand? Wa inna Yunus la min al mursaleen. In the same way, Yunus alayhi salatu wasalam was also one of the messengers. Is abaqa ila al fulk al mashhun. When he fled, ran to a laden ship, when he departed from his nation, without the express permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that was a mistake that he committed. Now he came and he mounted a ship, which was going perhaps in Shatt al-Arab, where these two rivers of Iraq, they join each other, Furat and Dajra. And this is a very big waterway now, Shatt al-Arab. And here some ship was going, and he also joined them. فَسَاهَمَ فَقَانَ مِنَ الْمُدْحَظِينَ. Then he cast lots with others and was the one who lost. Now what happened, according to the stories, riwayat, that there was the ship was trembling as if it will drown. They said there is some slave who has run away from his master in this boat. And that is why this boat is going to sink. So that person should be thrown into the water, into the river. Now they cast lots to know who is that person. So name of Yunus came, and he was then lifted and thrown in the river. فَالْتَقَمَهُ الْحُوتُ. And then he was swallowed by a fish, maybe some very big fish, some whale. وَهُوَ مُلِيمٌ. And he was reproached. فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. But had he not been from among those who glorify Allah, because there he glorified, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. He admitted that I have committed mistake, I have done wrong to myself, so Allah, you forgive me. لَلَبِسَ فِي بَطْنِهِ لَا يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Had he not been from among those who glorify Allah, he would have lived in the belly of the fish ila yawmi yub'asun, till the day of resurrection. فَنَبَزْنَاهُ بِالْعَرَاءِ وَهُوَ سَقِيمٌ. But then we threw him on a shore like a desert while he was sick, vomited. The fish vomited him out on the shore. وَعَبَّتْنَا عَلَيْهِ وَهُوَ سَقِيمٌ. He was very sick and ill. وَعَبَّتْنَا عَلَيْهِ شَجَرَةً مِّنْ يَقْطِينٍ. And we made to grow over him a plant of gourds. Now about this I have an information. Professor Ahmaduddin Mararavi, he was a inspector of school in Balochistan. And he says along the coast of Makran, there grows, there is some creepers, bale, which spread on the earth. And it has fruit, very sweet. And also there is some pesticide or insecticide effect in its leaves. So no, these insects, etc. come there. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they call it iggeen in that local Makrani language. They call it iggeen. Now this is yaqteen. Yaqteen and qaf is changed into gaf. As the Arabs say gul, gum. Instead of saying kum, they say gum. Instead of saying kul, they say gul. So iggeen is the changed form of yaqteen. So this was the plant that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made grow. Big leaves, so that they covered the body of Hazrat Yunus alayhi salam from the sun. And then there was the insecticide in the leaves. So no insects, no bacteria or this sort, they attacked him. So there he came to health again. وَأَنْبَتْنَا عَلَيْهِ شَجَرَةً مِّنْ يَقْطِينَ وَأَرْسَلْنَاهُ إِلَىٰ مِئَةِ أَلْفٍ أَوْ يَزِيدُونَ. Then he was sent back to 100,000 people. 100,000 people, the community of 100,000. فَأَسْلَمُوا فَآمَنُوا. And they came to believe in him. فَمَتَّعْنَاهُمْ إِلَىٰ حِينَ. So we let them have comforts in this world for some time. فَاسْتَفْتِهِمْ أَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ الْبَنَاتُ وَلَهُمُ الْبَنُونَ. Now, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ask them, the people of Arabia and Mecca, are for your lord's daughters, and for them are the sons. They like sons, but they have allotted daughters. They say the angels are the daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Am khalaqna al-malaikata inasan wa hum shahidun. Did we create these angels as females while they were witnesses? They were seeing it. So they say they are daughters. Ala innahum min ifkihim la yaqulun. Behold, it is surely of their own lie that they are saying, Walad Allah, that Allah has begotten. Wa innahum la kathibun. They are definitely telling a lie. He neither begot nor he was begotten. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad. Istafar banat al banin. He has chosen, according to their saying, he has chosen daughters over sons. Ma lakum kaifa tahkumun. What has happened to you? What type of judgments you are giving? Afala tazakkarun. Don't you get admonished? Am lakum sultanun mubeen. Do you have a clear authority or proof? Fatu bi kitabikum. Then you bring forth your book. In kuntum sadiqeen. If you are true. Wajalu bainahu wa bainal jinnati nasaba. And they have declared that there is a kinship between him, Allah, and the jinns. Walaqad alimatil jinnatu. And the jinns very well know, innahum la muhtaroon, that they will be presented before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now there is a hadith according to Mujahid. He was one of the disciples of Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. And many tafsiri riwayat, traditions of exegesis, we get through him from Abdullah ibn Abbas. They say that the mushrikeen, when they said that the angels are the daughters of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Abu Bakr asked them, then who are the mothers of these angels? They said, the daughters of the chiefs of the jinns were the mothers. So that they became the wives for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala according to their own mythology. In this way they were presenting a relationship, a kinship between Allah and jinns. Subhanallah yamma yasifun. Glorified is Allah above what they say, but they describe. Illa ibadallahi al-mukhlaseen. Except the servants of Allah, the ones who Allah has chosen for them, Himself. فَإِنَّكُمْ وَمَا تَعْبُدُونَ. Surely you and those whom you are worshipping, مَا أَنْتُمْ عَلَيْهِ بِفَاتِنِينَ. You cannot lead astray anyone against Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِلَّا مَنْ هُوَ صَالِ الْجَحِيمِ. Except the one who has to fall in the hellfire. وَمَا مِنَّا إِلَّا لَهُ مَقَامٌ مَعْلُومٌ. And now it is from the angels. And there is none of us, but he has an assigned situation. Every angel has a post assigned to him. You have to stay here. وَإِنَّا لَنَحْنُ الصَّافُونَ. And we always remain ranged in ranks. Now this is referring to the first ayah. وَالصَّافَّاتِ صَفَّنَ. وَإِنَّا لَنَحْنُ الصَّافِعُونَ. صَافُونَ. And we keep in rows, in lines, in ranks. وَإِنَّا نَحْنُ الْمُصَبِّحُونَ. And we are always glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنْ كَانُوا لَيَقُولُونَ. And definitely they are saying, لَوْ أَنَّا عِنْدَنَا ذِكْرًا مِنَ الْأَوَّلِينَ. Had we been given any admonition from the ancients, لَكُنَّا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. We would have been the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, exclusive for Him. فَكَفَرُوا بِهِ. But now they have belied it, rejected it. فَسَوْفَ يَعْلَمُونَ. So very soon they will come to know. وَلَقَدْ سَبَقَتْ كَلِمَتُنَا لِعِبَادِنَا الْمُرْسَلِينَ. These ayat are very important. A very big rule, divine rule, has been described in it. And certainly, our command has already gone forth for our servants, whom we sent as messengers. Whomsoever we send as messengers, or we have been sending as messengers, about them, this rule, this command had been decided beforehand. And what is that? إِنَّهُمْ لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ. Verily they will be helped. When their nations come and try to kill them, they will be saved. This is on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He takes the responsibility. إِنَّهُمْ لَهُمُ الْمَنْصُورُونَ وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. And verily our army, our host will be the victor. In the long run, the people who rejected the messengers, they were destroyed altogether. that happened to the people of Nuh and people of, you know, Hud and people of Saleh and people of Shu'aib and the cities to whom Lut was sent and so on and so forth. وَإِنَّ جُنْدَنَا لَهُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ فَتَوَلَّ عَنْهُمْ حَتَّى حِينَ. So, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you turn away from them for some time. Leave them. وَأَبْصِرْهُمْ فَسَوْفَ يُبْصِرُونَ. And watch them. And very soon, they will also see for themselves. أَفَبِعْذَابِنَا يَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. Do they want to hasten our chastisement? فَإِذَا أَنْدَرَ بِسَاحَتِهِمْ فَسَاءَ سَبْعُ الْمُنْذَرِينَ. When this chastisement of ours will descend in their courtyard, even will be the mourning for those people who were warned already. وَتَوَلَّ عَنُوا مَتَّاحِينَ. Again, repeat. And, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, turn away from them for a while. وَأَبْصِرْ فَصَوْفَ يُبْصِرُونَ. And watch. And they will also see for themselves. سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ أَمَّا يَصِفُونَ. Glory be for your Lord. He is the Lord of majesty, authority, amma yasifoon, and He is above and high from all those things which they are describing. Wa salamun ala al-mursaleen. Peace on all the messengers. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. And praise for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Lord of all the worlds. Now Surah Sa'd. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم صاد والقرآن ذي الذكر. صاد, this is the first surah which is starting with one letter. There have been letters alif lam mim, alif lam ra, alif lam mim ra, alif lam mim صاد, and so on and so forth, kaf ha ya ain صاد. But there are three surahs of Quran which start with only one letter. The first one is this صاد. Then will come Surah Qaf, then will be Surah Noon. Saad wal Quran is his zikr. By the Quran, which is full of admonition and reminding. Now, what is Jawab Qasm? Maqsum alayh. That is understood. We have to guess according to Surah Yasin. Wal Quran is his zikr, inna kalabin al mursaleen. This Quran, which has the admonition and the reminding for the humanity, this is the proof, clear proof, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you are the messenger of Allah. بَلِ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا فِي عِزَّةٍ وَشِقَاقٍ. But those who disbelieve are in false pride, and they are totally opposed to it. كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ. And before them, how many a generation we destroyed, فَنَادَوْ. Then they cried to each other, وَلَا تَحِينَ مَنَاسِ. But the time of escape had passed. Now there was no escape from the chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَجَبُوا أَنْ جَاءَهُمْ مُنْذِرٌ مِّنْهُمْ. And they are wondering that to them has come a warner from among themselves, a human being, a person from their own nation. وَقَالَ الْكَافِرُونَ هَذَا سَاحِرٌ كَذَّابٌ. And the disbelievers are saying that he is a sorcerer and a liar, كَذَّابٌ. أَجْعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. Has he merged all the gods into one god? We had a god, we knew a big god, the biggest god, but along with that big god, there were so many other gods and goddesses. But now, it is a very strange thing that he is saying, أَجْعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. He has merged all the gods into one god. إِنَّ هَذَا لَشَيْءٌ عُجَابٌ. This is something very astounding, very astonishing. وَانْتَلَقَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْهُمْ. And the chiefs from among them, they just left, departed. Leave him, leave Muhammad, what he's saying. We can't even listen to it. وَانْتَلَقَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْهُمْ. أَنْ اِمْشُوا وَاسْبِرُوا عَلَىٰ آلِهَتِكُمْ. And they said to their common people also, go from here, don't listen what he's saying. And persevere about your gods, cling to them. Don't listen to him. He's falsifying them. He's saying they are false gods. No. You cling to them and persevere in it. وَاسْبِرُوا عَلَىٰ آلِهَتِكُمْ. إِنَّ هَذَا شَيْءٌ لَشَيْءٌ يُرَادٌ. Definitely, What is Muhammad saying today, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He has some personal motives behind it. He wants to become your chief. He wants to attain authority. Something, yurad. He aims at something when he is saying this. مَا سَمِعْنَا بِهَذَا فِي الْمِلَّةِ الْآخِرَةِ We have never heard about these things in the previous ummats, in the previous faiths. إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا اخْتِلَاقٌ This is nothing but an invention. أَوْنْزِلَ عَلَيْهِ ذِكْرُ مِنْ بَيْنِنَا Has the admonition and the reminding been sent to him, giving us? We are the chieftains. We have more wealth. We have more strength. If Allah had to send something, some revelation, He could have chosen one of us, one of the chieftains. أَوْنْزِلَ عَلَيْهِ ذِكْرُ مِنْ بَيْنِنَا بَلْ هُمْ فِي شَكِّمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِي But they are in doubt about my zikr, about my remembrance. بَلْ لَمَّا يَذُوقُ عَذَاب Actually, the reason is that they have not up till now tasted our chastisement. When they will taste our chastisement, then they will know everything. أَمْ إِنَّهُمْ خَزَائِنُ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ الْعَزِيزِ الْوَهَّابِ Do they own the treasures of the mercy of your Lord, who is Al-Aziz, mighty, and Wahhab, bestower? You know, this Nabuwa or Risala is a mercy, as we saw. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives His mercy to whomsoever He likes. He has selected Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is His choice. Now, they are saying, He should have selected somebody else, some Walid bin Mughira, or some or other, you know, big person, very wealthy, and a chief among the Quraysh. أَمْ لَهُمْ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ Do they have the sovereignty of the heavens and the earth? وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا And whatever is in between them? فَلْيَرْتَقُوا الْأَسْبَابِ فِي الْأَسْبَابِ So they let them climb up the heaven by any means. جُنْدٌ مَا هُنَالِكَ مَحْزُومٌ مِنَ الْأَحْزَابِ They are another routed host of the confederates that were there. Before them also there were so many people, so many nations. They were destroyed. This is again a group which will have that final destruction. كَذَبَتْ قَبْلَهُمْ قَوْمُ نُوحٍ Before them, the people of Nuh, they belied. وَعَادٌ And the nation of Aad. وَفِرْعَوْنُ ذُو الْأَوْتَادِ And in the same way, Fir'aun, the one who had the tent pegs, is such a big army that for the tents, you know, there were pegs to erect the tents. And these pegs were so many in number, so many horses or mules were laden with the pegs only. ذُو الْأَوْتَادِ وَسَمُودُ And in the same way, the nation of Samud, وَقَوْمُ لُوتٍ And the people of Lut, وَأَصْحَابُ الْأَيْكَةِ And the people of the thicket, people of that jungle. أُولَٰئِكَ الْأَحْزَابُ They were the Ahzab, they were the groups, they were the parties, they were the hosts, they were destroyed before them. إِن كُلُّ لِلَّهِ كَذَّبَ الرُّسُلُ All of them, they belied their messengers, فَاقَ عِقَابُ And they then became deserving of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا يَنْظُرُ هَٰؤُلَىٰ إِلَّا صَيْحَةً وَاحِدَةً مَا لَهَا مِنْ فَوَاقٍ And these people are not waiting for anything else but a shout, صَيْحَةً وَاحِدَةً A very loud shout in which there will be no pause. Continuous. Loud shout, continuous. That will be the cause of their death. وَمَا يَنْظُرُ هَٰؤُلَىٰ إِلَّا صَيْحَةً وَاحِدَةً مَا لَهَا مِنْ فَوَاقٍ وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا عَجِّلْ لَنَا قِطَّنَا قَبْلَ يَوْمِ الْحِسَابِ And they are saying, O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Lord, give us our portion, whatever you have to give us, good or bad, punishment or reward. Give us before the day of the reckoning. We want it early. You make the decision now. We don't want to wait till the death and until the resurrection, until the end of the or the day of judgment. اسْبِرْ عَلَىٰ مَا يَقُولُونَ O Muhammad, you have patience on what they are saying. وَاذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا دَاوُودَ وَذَا الْأَيْدِ And now you mention here our servant Dawood, alayhi salatu wasalam, ذَا الْأَيْدِ who was the possessor of strength, إِنَّهُ أَوَّابُ And he always turned to us in prayer. إِنَّا سَخَّرْنَا الْجِبَالَ مَعَهُ يُسَبِّحْنَا بِالْعَشِيِّ وَالْإِشْرَاقِ We have subjected the mountains with him because they used to glorify us with him at nightfall and sunrise. When Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam, he read the Psalms, you know, the book Zabur is actually a collection of the Psalms. So, and he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, had given him a very beautiful, very voice which has a melody in it. So then, you know, the mountains also and the birds also joined with him. Inna sakhkharna al-jibala ma'ahu. We have subjected the mountains with him, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the evenings and also in the on the sunrise. Wattaira bahshura. And in the same way, the birds which were gathered duly, all were turning towards Allah, turning to him. Washadadna mulkahu. And we have strengthened and fortified his kingdom. وَآتَيْنَاهُ الْحِكْمَةَ وَفَصْلَ الْخِطَابِ. And we had given to him the wisdom and decisive sayings and speech. He could decide the matters very soon, understand the matter, decide it, and decide it very decisively. وَهَلْ أَتَاكَ نَبَأُ الْخَصْمِ. And has the news of two disputants come to you, is the Tasawwurul Mihrab, when they climbed over the wall of the sanctuary in the palace, you know, he had fixed a one place, sanctuary, where he used to pray. Now he was there alone. There was nobody except near. And on, you know, palace, there must have been guards at the gates, but some two people, they climbed over the wall and came to him suddenly. Is dakhalu ala Dawuda, when they entered upon Dawud, fa fazi'a minhum, he felt danger from them. He was frightened at them. Qalu la takhaf, they said, they want to kill me perhaps, do some harm to me. How have they come? Defying all the guards of the palaces, they have reached here. So he was frightful. Qalu la takhaf, they said, you don't have fear. Khasmane baga baduna ala badin. We are two disputants. We have a dispute among us. One of us has oppressed the other. Faakum bainana bil haq. So now you decide between us with the truth. Wala tushtit. Don't postpone. Don't say come tomorrow. This is my private time. And I am praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why do you come and disturb me? Wala tushtit. We want the decision now and here. وَحْدِنَا إِلَىٰ سَوَائِ السِّرَاطِ. And guide us to the straight way, straight path. إِنَّ هَذَا أَخِي. Now the one said, he is my brother. لَهُ تِسْعُونَ وَتِسْعُونَ نَعْجَةً. To him belongs 99 ewes. Ewes, you know, the sheeps, but a special type of sheep. لَهُ تِسْعُونَ وَتِسْعُونَ نَعْجَةً. He has 99 ewes. وَلِيَ نَعْجَةٌ وَاحِدًا. And I have only one ewe. فَقَالَكْ فِلْنِيهَا وَعَزَّنِي فِي الْخِطَابِ. Now he says, give me, hand me over that one also. And he has oppressed and overcome me in argument. He has overpowered me. He has 99. I have only one. And he says, hand that over also to me. قَالَ لَقَدْ ظَلَمَكَ بِسْوَالِ نَعْجَتِكَ إِلَىٰ نِعَاجِهِ. Dawud said, well, he is doing wrong. While he is asking that you should hand over your own Eve also to him. فَإِنَّ كَسِيرًا مِنَ الْخُلَطَاءِ لَيَبْغِي بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَىٰ بَعْضُهُمْ. And definitely, those people, you know, who are partners in this world, in business, etc., in families, they do wrong to each other. There's no nothing new in it. People do wrong to each other. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Except those who believe in Allah and who do good deeds. وَقَلِيلٌ مَا هُمْ. And such people are not very much. They are very few. وَظَنَّ دَاوُود. And then suddenly it came to Dawood. It dawned on him. أَنَّمَا فَتَنَّاهُ. Actually, this was a trial for him. We had put him to a test through this. فَاسْتَغْفَرَ رَبَّهُ. So he asked for the forgiveness from his Lord. وَخَرَّ رَاكِمْ وَنَابِ. And he fell down, first in ruku, And you know, then in sajda, and he turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now I shall explain it later. This is ayatul sajda. So perform sajda. فَغَفَرْنَا لَهُ. So we forgave him. ذَلِكَ. That mistake or sin, whatsoever we may call it, we forgave it to him. وَإِنَّ لَهُ عِنْدَنَا لَزُلْفَى وَحُسْنَ مَعَابٍ. And surely for him is an access to us and goodly resort. Now actually this Surah As-Saff has many incidents quoted here. Very briefly. The details are neither in the Quran nor in the authentic ahadith. But only references are from the Israeli riwayat, the Israelite traditions. And the Israelis, people, these Yahud, they had the bad habit of assigning very bad things to their prophets. He did this and he did that and he did that. About Lut, maybe you might be knowing or not, that his two daughters committed adultery with him. And this is written in Torah. In the same way, there is the story that Dawud alayhi salam had so many wives. He was a king. You know, harem of the kings on those days used to be full of wives. But there was one of his generals, Uriah. Uriah's wife was very beautiful. Someday, Dawud happened to see her. And he liked to marry her. Then he asked Uriah that you should divorce your wife so that I can marry her. So this is the story. Rather there, you know, in Torah, the story goes further. That he refused. But then Dawud, alayhi salam, he sent Uriah on an expedition in which it was sure that he will be killed. So he was killed, and when now that woman became a widow, now he married her. So we don't know how much is the truth. But maybe something, some truth in it might have been, because Quran is saying something. And we don't find any other explanation, you know. And this is the principle of tafsir and exegesis of Quran, that those things which are referred to in Quran briefly, if you have any details in the former books, scriptures, then we can take the things from there. Haddesu al Bani Israel wala haraj. This is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You can take and accept the traditions from Bani Israel, and there is no haraj in it, nothing wrong in it. Anyhow, Allah best knows what was the incident. But one thing is sure, that something wrong was there in the heart of Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took this method of warning him so that he becomes conscious of his ill intention or whatever he was going to do. And this is the way how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saves the prophets from doing something wrong. Not that they have no intentions. We have the tradition that Prophet said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that when I was young, twice it happened that I decided to go to those, you know, melas, where there was singing also and dancing also, and, you know, stories were being told. But what happened? I started from my home. In the way, somewhere I sat for some rest, I slept. Kept sleeping whole night. In the morning I wake up and the time was gone. So Allah saved me. Again, once more, the same happened. So Allah saves, you know. And this is the ismah, masoom. The prophets are masoom. They are saved. They are protected. Not that no idea of a bad thing can come to their mind. No, no. They are human beings. There can be. Ideas can come. We have read in Suratul Hajj, وَمَا مِن نَبِيٍ. But whenever he, whosoever Nabi and Messenger we have been sending, when they had some plannings of their own, إِذَا تَمَنَّا أَلْقَ الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَتِهِ. When they were planning themselves, what was coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it was absolutely protected. There couldn't be anything wrong in it from the shayateen. But when he was himself planning, there could be some mistake. But then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps him safe. And he is, at a proper time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lets him know that you are going towards the wrong direction. So this is what happened here. So Dawood came to know that he had some wrong thing in his mind. So he repented, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted his repentance. Ya Dawood, inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard. O Dawood, we have made you the vice tyrant on earth. Fahkum bayna an-nas bil-haq. So you should judge between people with truth and justice. Wala tattabi' al-hawa. Don't follow your lusts. Don't follow your desires. Fayudillaka an sabilillah. They will definitely lead you astray from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Inna allazina yadilluna an sabilillah. Verily those who go astray from the path of Allah, lahum azabun shadeed, for them is a very strong, severe chastisement. Bima nasu yawm al-hisab, because they just forgot that the time is to come when I'll have to account for it. وَمَا خَلَقْنَا السَّمَاءَ وَالْأَرْضَ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا بَاطِلًا. And we have not created the heaven and the earth and whatever is between them without any purpose. ذَلِكَ ظَنُّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. This is the thought of those who disbelieve. فَوَيْلٌ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنَ النَّارِ. So woe to those people who disbelieve from the fire. أَمْ نَجْعَلَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَالْمُفْسِدِينَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Will we hold those people who come to believe and they do good deeds as those who are the mischief mongers in the earth? They must be repaid accordingly. Whosoever is doing good deeds, he must be rewarded. Good reward. And whosoever has been a mischief monger, he should be punished. Am najalu al-muttaqina kal-fujjar. Or is it possible that we can make equal those who feared us and those who were miscreants? The answer is no, it is not possible. Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka mubarakun liyadabbaru ayatihi. This Quran is a book that we have sent down to thee, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is Mubarak, blessed. لِيَدَّبَّرُ آيَاتِهِ. So that they should ponder over its revelations. Ponder over. Dive deep into the meanings of this, the revelations of Quran. وَمَا يَذَّكَّرُ وَلِيَذَّكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. So that the people who have an understanding, they get admonished and reminded. وَوَهَبْنَا لِدَاوُدَ سُلَيْمَانَ. And we blessed Dawood with Sulaiman. We gave him as a son. Naim al-Abd. What an excellent servant he was. Innahu awwab. He also kept turning to us in prayers. Is urida alayhi bil-ashiyyis safinat ul-diyad. When there were presented to him in the evening, standing steeds, swift-footed. Here had armies. So armies, there were steeds also, horses of good pedigree. And he was inspecting them. Faqala, but he kept busy long, so that the Salatul Asr, you know, this time passed. Faqala, inni ahbabtu hubbal khair an zikri rabbi. Then he repented. I love this wealth of this world. These horses are the wealth of this world. I loved them so much that they became a bar, and they prevented me from the Salatul Asr, from the zikr of my Lord, from the remembrance of my Lord. Hatta tawarat bil hijab, until the sun got hidden in the curtains. It was set. The time of Maghrib has come. Now in that condition, he was so much sad, so much grieved, that in, you know, a special condition, he said, bring back these horses to me. رُدُّهَا فَتَفِقَ مَصْحًا بِسُوقِ وَالْعَنَابِ. And then he started striking and smiting them in their necks and in their legs. So he was cutting them. وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّا سُلَيْمَانَ وَأَلْقَيْنَا عَلَىٰ كُرْسِيهِ جَسَدًا ثُمَّ أَنَابَ. Another event of Hazrat Sulaiman's life. And we certainly tried Sulaiman, and we cast upon his throne a mere body. Now this also needs a very long description. I can't go into that details. I told you, these are some incidents of the lives of Sulaiman and Dawood. Details are not here in Quran, only references, flying references. So for this, if somebody wishes, he should either consult the former scriptures or the ahadith or the tafasir. Now there's a prayer of Sulaiman alayhi salam. Qala rabbi ighfirli. Oh my Lord, forgive me. Wahabli mulkan la yambaghi li ahadin min ba'di. And bestow on me a kingdom such as may not suit to anyone after me. You bless me with a kingdom with which you will not bless anybody else till the end. Now the kingdom of Sulaiman was not very great. But you know, he had power over wind. He had powers over jinns. He had power over the animals, birds. So all these things. None else in the whole human history is like Sulaiman alayhi salatu wasalam. Neither before him nor after him. And that is the dua. Rabbi ghfirli wa habli mulkan. Give me a kingdom. La yambaghi li ahadin min ba'di. Which nobody after me can have. إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَحَّابُ. Verily, you are the giver, the bestower. فَسَخَّرْنَا لَهُ الرِّيحِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, then we subjected to him the wind. تَجْرِي بِأَمْرِهِ. According to his command, it blew. تُخَانْ حَيْسُ أَصَابُ. Very softly and gently, wherever he had directed. The wind to now blow towards east, or now blow towards west. And his ships were moving in the seas. And you know, always, according to his command, the winds was blowing so that they were taking the ships of Sulaiman in the required direction. وَشَيَاطِينَ كُلَّ بَنَّاءٍ وَغَوَّاصٍ. And this is again, no other king has been given this authority. Sulaiman alayhi salam, to him we made the jinnat. They were subjected to him. And they were for him the builders, banna, waghawwas, and divers in the oceans. Wa akharina muqarrarina fil asfad. And there were others also who were chained in the fetters. Khaza ata'una, we said to Sulaiman, this is our bestowing upon you. Famnun aw amsik. Now you can share others also in it. Shares all these blessings with people. Or if you like, you can keep it with you. بغیر حساب. We shall not have any reckoning over this. وَإِنَّ لَهُ إِنْدَنَا لَزُلْفَى وَحُسْنَ مَعَابٍ. And definitely for him is with us a very goodly resort and a very near position. وَذْكُرْ عَبْدَنَا أَيُّوب. And mention here our servant Ayyub, Job, alayhi salatu wassalam, is nada rabbahu, when he called upon his Lord, Rabbi inni massaniya shaitanu binusbin wa azab. Oh my Lord, surely Satan has touched me with toil and chastisement. Urkuz bi rijlika. Allah sent the revelation, stamp with your foot on the earth. Haza muhtasalun. Now when he stamped on the earth, there, you know, gushed a spring from the earth. And Allah said, now this is for washing and cold drink also. وَوَهَبْنَا لَهُ أَهْلَهُ. And we gave back to him his family. وَمِسْلَهُ مَهَوْ. And another more family people like them. رَحْمَةً مِنَّا. It was all mercy from our side. وَذِكْرَى. And a reminding. لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. For those who understand. وَخُذْ بِيَدِكَ زِغْزًا. And now you hold in your hand a bundle of twigs. فَضْرِبْ بِهِ. And strike with it. وَلَا تَحْنَسْ. And don't break your oath. He had said in some, you know, time of anger, I will strike you, to his wife, he had said, 100 stripes. Now, he was sorry. I had said this, how to do it? 100 stripes to this woman, she might be killed. So Allah said, okay, you take a bundle of twigs, 100 twigs in your hands and strike once. So this will be the fulfillment of your oath. We had found him a very persevering person. Name al-Abd. He was a very fine servant of ours. Innahu awwab. And he was also always turning towards us. Waskur abdan ibadana Ibrahim wa Ishaq wa Yaqub. And mention here also our servants Ibrahim, Ishaq and Yaqub. Ulil Adi wa Nabsar. They were all people who had might and vision. Inna akhlasnahum bi khalisatin zikraddar. We had chosen them with a most pure purpose, and that is the remembrance of the final abode. وَإِنَّهُمْ إِنْدَنَا لَمْنَ الْمُصْطَفَيْنَ الْأَخْيَارِ. And surely they are with us of the chosen, the excellent people. فَسْكُرْ إِسْمَعِيلَ وَالْيَسَعَ وَالْذُلْكِفْرِ. And mention also Ismail and Yasa and Zulkifl. وَكُلُّ مِنَ الْأَخْيَارِ. All of them were from our excellent bondsmen. هَذَا ذِكْرِ. This is a reminding or admonition. وَإِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ حُسْنَ مَعَابِ. And definitely for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there's going to be a goodly resort. And what is that? Jannati Adnin. These will be the gardens of perpetuity. Mufattahat allahumul abwab. And their doors are open, ready to welcome the people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends there. Muttaqeena fiha. They will be sitting there, reclining. Yad'una fiha. And they will be calling for, ordering for, there, bifakihatin kasiratin, much of fruit, wa sharab, and drinks. Wa indahum qasiratu tarf atrab. And with them there will be maidens of restraining glances and of equal age. Haza ma tu'aduna li yawmil hisab. This is what you are being promised for the day of reckoning, for the day of judgment. Inna haza la rizquna ma lahu min nafad. And this is our provision. It is not going to be finished at any time. Hada wa inna littaghina la sharra ma'ab. This is for those people who are sent to the hell, to the heaven, to the paradise. But for those people who were transgressors, taghin la sharra ma'ab, for them there is going to be an evil resort, Jahannam. That is Jahannam, yaslaunaha. They will enter it, fabis al mihad, and that is a very bad resting place. Hada fal yazuku hamimun wa ghassaq. This is for you. Now they should taste this boiling water and pus from the wounds. وَآخِرُ مِنْ شَكْلِهِ أَزْوَاج. And punishments like these of various kinds. هَذَا فَوْجٌ مُقْتَحِمٌ مَعَاكُمْ. Now people already in the hell, they will say, oh, another group is coming. هَذَا فَوْجٌ مُقْتَحِمٌ مَعَاكُمْ. They are coming towards you, rushing towards you. لَا مَرْحَبًا بِهِمْ. No welcome for them. إِنَّهُمْ سَالُ النَّارِ. They are going to enter the fire. Qalu bal antum. Now the newcomers will say to those who are already there in the hell, la marhaban bikum. No welcome for you. Antum qaddamtumuhu lana. You are our elders. You are the former generation. You have brought all this to us. You were on the wrong path and we followed you. Fabis al qarar. And this is a very bad resting place. Qalu rabbana man qaddama lana haza. And they will say, oh, our Lord, whosoever has brought these things to us, فَزِدْهُ عَذَابًا زَيْفًا فِي النَّارِ. For them, you should increase the chastisement in the, and double it in the fire. وَقَالُوا مَا كُنَّا لَا نَرَى رِجَالًا كُنَّا نَعُدُّهُ مِنَ الْأَشْرَارِ. And they will say, what has happened, we are not seeing amongst us. Those people whom we were thinking that they are among the most vicious people. اتخذناهم سخريا. We used to laugh at them, mock at them. أم زاغت عنهم الأبصار. What has happened? Our eyes, you know, they have been turned from them. إن ذلك لحق تخاصم أهل النار. Now this disputing between themselves, between the people who will be in the hell, is true. It is going to take place. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا مُنْزِرْ. Say, O Muhammad, I am only a warner. وَمَا مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ إِلَّا اللَّهُ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارِ. There's no God except the one who is omnipotent, alone. رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. He is the Lord of the heavens and the earth. وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. And whatsoever is in between them. الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفَّارِ. He is all-powerful. He has the total authority. But he is also forgiving. قُلْ هُوَ نَبَأٌ عَظِيمٌ. Say, this is going to be a very big news. أَنْتُمْ عَنْهُ مُعْرِضُونَ. And you are turning away from that. What are the news? That you will be resurrected. And you know, you will be brought to the book. And then maybe some of you are sent to the heaven and the rest are sent to the hell. So this is Nabaun Azim. This is a very big news. Antum anhu muridun. You are turning from it. Ma kana li min ilmin bil mala'il ala is yaqtasimun. I don't have any knowledge of the highest exalted assembly of the Malaikat al-Muqarrabun when they were dissenting about the vicegerents of Adam. In Yuha, ilayya illa annama ana nadhirun mubin. Only it is being revealed to me, sent by revelation, that I am nothing but a warner, clear warner. وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ. And just recall, when your Lord said to the angels, إِنِّي خَالِقٌ بَشَرًا مِّن طِينٍ. I am going to make a person, a human being, create a mortal from clay. Now this story of Adam and Iblis, here it is coming for the final and seventh time in the Quran. It is there in Surah Al-Baqarah, section 4. Surah Al-Araf, section 2. Then it was in Surah Al-Hijr. Then Surah Bani Israel, Surah Kahf. Then Surah Taha. And now finally, this is the seventh. This is Surah Sa'd. And when your Lord said to the angels, I am going to create a mortal from clay. فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ. So when I have shaped him, وَنَفَقْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. And have blown into him from my own spirit. فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. So at that time, you will have to fall before him in prostration. فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ. So all the angels fell prostrate all together, إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ, except Iblis. But he was not an angel, he was a jinn. إِسْتَكْبَرَ. He showed arrogance. وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. And he became one of the disbelievers. قَالَ يَا إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَعَكَ. Now Allah said to him, O Iblis, what has prevented you أَنْ تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ. That you prostrate before him whom I have created with both of my hands. I have created human being, Adam, with both of my hands. What does it mean? What I think is that this Alamul Khalq and Alamul Amr, both are joined in man. And man is the only creation which has both the worlds in him. Now this is Alamul Amr, Alamul Khalq. To Alamul Amr belongs Malaika, angels, and our spirits. To Alamul Khalq belongs our this body, animal aspect of our existence. Now jinnat are only alam-e khalq. All these animals are only alam-e khalq. All this universe is all only alam-e khalq. Alam-e abr, only malaika, but they don't have bodies. They don't have the alam-e khalq. The only creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in which both these, you know, worlds have joined together is man. I think this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means when he says, I have created this man with both of my hands. Astakbarta. Now this question is to Iblis. Are you arrogant? Am kunta min al-aaleen? Or you are want to exalt yourself? Qala ana khairun minhu. He said, I am better than him. Khalaqtani min narin wa khalaqtahu min teen. You created me from fire and created him out of clay. قَالَ فَخْرُجْ مِنْهَا فَإِنَّكَ رَجِيمٌ. Allah said, okay, go forth, go out, go away from here. And because now you are accursed. وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكَ لَعْنَتِي إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الدِّينِ. And my curse shall remain with you till the day of resurrection. قَالَ رَبِّ فَانْزِرْنِي إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. He said, okay, my Lord, now give me respite till the day they shall be raised. قَالَ فَإِنَّكَ مِنَ الْمُنْزَرِينَ. Allah said, okay, go. That respite is granted to you. إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْوَقْتِ الْمَعْلُومِ. Till the day of the known time. قَالَ فَبَعِزَّتِكَ. Now he said, I swear by your honor, لَأُوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. I will certainly mislead all of them together. إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمَ الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Except those from him whom you have chosen for yourself. قَالَ فَالْحَقُّ وَالْحَقَّ أَقُولُ. Allah said, okay, then the truth is, and I am saying the truth, لَأَمْلَأَنَّ جَهَنَّمَ مِنْكَ وَمِمَّنْ تَبِعَكَ مِنْهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. I will fill the hell with you and whosoever from the progeny of Adam follows you, from all of you, I will fill the hell. قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ مِنْ أَجْرٍ. O Muhammad, say to them, I am not asking you any reward, any wage, من أجر وما أنا من المتكلفين. And I am not from among those who are pretenders or imposters. إن هو إلا ذكر للعالمين. This Quran is nothing but a reminding admonition for the worlds. وَلَتَعْلَمُنَّ نَبَاهُ بَعْدَهِينَ. And certainly you will know the truth, the news that it is giving you. The reality will come to you after some time. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.